This origins of life course consists of 6 units. Each unit is divided up into varying numbers of subunits. At the end of each subunit, you will find a quiz that contains 1 to 4 questions. These quizzes do not count towards your grade and are meant to check your comprehension of the material up to that point. We will also have optional activities in 2 of the units to help reinforce the material. Your final grade will be determined by the unit exams and 1 peer-reviewed assignment. You will see 6 unit exams throughout the course. We'll give you more details on the peer review assignment later in the course. To receive your certificate of completion, you'll need to get a cumulative score of 60% or greater. We also want to take a moment to remind you of the discussion forums. As this course aims to present origins of life from a diversity of perspectives, the discussion forum should be a rich and lively place to discuss this open area of investigation. Please be respectful of other students' perspectives and encourage expansive, creative explorations of origins of life research. This course is divided into the following units: an introduction, chemical origins, chemical commonalities, early life, evolution, and finally, astrobiology and general theories of life. In the introduction, we will go over some of the overarching ideas required for thinking about the origins of life. We will then move on to a presentation of chemical origins, where we discuss the chemistry of the early Earth and the foundation of chemical processes connected with life. Next, we move on to describe the biochemistry of life and what is chemically common to all of life in more detail. We spend units 4 and 5 discussing the early evolution of life and evolutionary processes in general. Finally, we conclude the course with broad perspectives on how origins of life research applies to astrobiology and connects to general theories of life.